Hi, welcome to Microcontroller and Embedded System Laboratory. In this video, we are going to discuss on a program to find the largest and the smallest number in an array of 32-bit numbers. In this program, we are going to find the smallest element in an array. So we are going to have an instruction called as BLS. If you are finding the largest of a number, the same code segment has to be changed to BHI. There are six numbers for which we are going to find the smallest element now, and these are defined as DCD, which stands for defined constant data. This allocates half word on a 4-byte boundary. The numbers that we have are 32-bit, so we have the numbers 444, 22s, 1s, 3s and A's, as well as 8. So there are 6 numbers which are stored in a location which is labeled as value 1. Since there are 6 numbers on which we are finding the smallest element, we initialize the counter R5 to 5 numbers. If you have 7 numbers, you need to be initialized to 6. Now first we start by loading the address of the first value into the register R1. The second instruction we have is a post index addressing, that is, it is going to add the offset after transferring the value is being made. So we have R1 contains the first address of the first number, which is 4s, and that content, that is the number 4444, is loaded into the register R2, and R4 is added with the offset value as 4 because it is defined as DCD. Then we are storing the next number, second number, which is 2s here, into the register R4, and then R1 has been incremented with the offset value and it will be pointing to the third number. Now in my registers we have the number, the first number in R2, the second number in R4. We compare the two numbers, that is R2 and R4 is made the comparison. We are going to execute this instruction going to loop 1 when we have the numbers are lower or same. LS stands for unsigned lower or same. On comparing R2 and R4, if the number is lower, it goes to the loop 1. Else we are moving the contents from R2 to R4. Now in this instruction our number is 444 and 222. On comparing we see that this instruction is higher and we want the lower, it goes to the next instruction rather than going to the labeled location as loop 1. Now we move the contents of R4 into the register R2. Now R2 contains all 2s here. Then the next instruction getting executed is subs. That means the flag contents are being updated. Conditional flags are getting updated when we prefix it with an S with the sub instruction. R5 is decremented by 1. It compare the value whether R5 is 0. We still have few more numbers to make the comparison. So it says branch not equal to loop. It goes back to the loop. Now R1 is pointing to the third number. Third number is moved to the register R4 and then R1 is incremented by the offset value as 4. Now R1 will be pointing to the next fourth number. It makes the comparison again. The next number is 11 is compared with 2s here. Now we see that it is lesser. So it will come to the next instruction where the content of R4 is moved to the register R2. So we have 1 is moved to the register R2 now. Again, R5 is subtracted. R5 becomes 3. Compare. Now 3 is not equal to 0. It goes back to the loop label location. The next number is 3s which are being there. It is getting loaded to R4. Again, 111 is compared with 333. Now here it says branch less than, yes, R2 is less than R4. So it goes to the loop label location where it decrements the counter by 1. So R5 becomes 2. The next number is moved to the register R4. Again, the value of R4 is compared with R2. This number is larger, so it goes back by decrementing the counter by 1. R5 becomes 1. The next number that we have in our register, R4, is 8. All this number 8888 is compared with the value of R2, which is 111. Again, the value of R2 is lesser, it decrements R5 by 1. And then now R5 is 0. We have finished all the values on the comparison. The least value that we want is stored in the register R2. Now the next instruction gets executed, that is LDR R4 equal to 0. That means it is moving the address of the result, which is a DCD, into the register R4. We are moving the result label location into the register R4. R4 is now pointing to the result label location, which is a DCD. We store the answer, that is the least number, which is 11111. That is the least number that we have stored in an array, is moved to the label location called as the result. And we can view the answer. When you go to that location, we can see the least number being stored in that location. The next instruction is an infinite loop where it simply branches to the label location called as SS. It comes back to the same labeled location, and this is a convenient way of stopping the program. In this way, we have learned how to trace the smallest element in an array of 32-bit number. Now, the same program can be repeated to find the largest element by substituting BLS with BHI, where BHI stands for branch unsigned higher, and then again R2 will contain the largest number in the register R2. Again, we move the same largest number into the label location R4, and then you can see the result being available in that label location. In this way, we have discussed to find the smallest and the largest element in an array of 6 numbers. Thank you for watching this video. If you liked it, do support the channel by clicking the like button and subscribe to the channel.